in the bathroom. I put your hands on the toilet.
Is that my vibe right there? Check, check.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yo, give it up for Mayor for the worst introduction of all time.
Hey.
That was the, I don't even know. He was like giving you guys instructions for like 45 minutes. I thought you were going to launch a missile or something. It was like,
go on your phone. Put Arab-Persian-Alpine on.
It was like so complicated. It's crazy out here, man. And Portland, and the thing is, I see a couple. I thought I was the only black person in Portland, but no. It's us three, and we're here. We are in here. You know what I'm saying? We are in here, bro. There's another one? Oh, bro, it's my bad. It's dark down there. I can't even see you. I didn't see you until you smiled. But there, you're there. You're in there. What's your name? Kevin? Yeah, that's not even a black name, brother. What's Kevin? We're gonna start calling you Jamal. Jamal! We're in here, Jamal! We are in here! I love it. Jamal, you're my man right now, dog. You're the coolest. No, well, I'm cool. Guys, this is like the serious section. So serious. None of you ever go to an airport because honestly, you're never getting through. Never. With me, it's cool. They let me right through because I'm black. Like, they look at me, I'm black. They're like, nigga, you good. Like, I walk right in. It's not even hard. But honestly, I got the one time I had a hard time, like, with racism at the airport, wasn't even from the security people. It was from a white lady who was at the airport, and she was, like, on my flight. And I was getting by her to get to my seat. And she had the audacity, Jamal, she had the audacity to take her purse and take it and move it to the other side and clutch it. I was sitting next to her, bro. Where did she think I was gonna go? At 20,000 feet, I was just gonna snatch her purse, kick open the exit door, like, woo! Like $27 in a Macy's credit card? No! That's so stupid. Doesn't she know I'm just gonna wait till we land before I steal? It's interesting. And here's the thing. Let me tell you a secret, Jamal. Because I'm actually half black, half Persian. Yeah. So I'm the most dangerous person in the room. Yeah. 100%. Like, think of it. What a white person hears, I'm half black, half Persian. All he hears is half nigga, half terrorist. That's what he hears. Carjack, hijack. I'm capable of anything. I can't even talk hip hop. I'm like, yo, Jamal, I'm the bomb. He's like, I might really mean it. You know what I'm saying? And that's the thing. We got to change the world. We got to change the world from stereotypes. Stereotypes aren't. I don't understand how stereotypes even happen. Like, who picks these stereotypes? I'm looking around this room, and there's a lot of diverse people. I see the Persians are here. There's a bunch of Persians. Everyone's afraid. I don't work for immigration, guys. You can be loud. Like, we're the Persians. Arabs? Are there Arabs? Security? But there's like all types of people. Are there any Indians here? 1 billion of you and only you showed up? You couldn't have just put something out on Instagram? Nothing? Well, thank you, Gupta, for being here. I appreciate it. Kidding. Asians. Any Asians here? Yeah, Asians. Another country with 1 billion people. Another one. You guys get stereotyped the most, and it's the worst. Like, so what? You're good at math. Who cares? You're good at math. You know what I'm saying? That's amazing. That's a good thing. I hate those stereotypes. Those are just stupid things. Like, thank you for being here. What's your name?
Me?
Yeah. Michelle? Are you friends with Kevin? What? Yo, okay. What, and your name?
Anna.
Okay, sounds like someone in dry cleaning. All I'm saying is, I'm kidding, that's a stupid stereotype. Don't even laugh. Thank you guys. Thank you guys, both of you, for being here. Like, thank you for representing Asian people and being here. Thank you for being here and not out there driving, because let's be honest, that one's true. That one's not, it's like, Fast and Furious my ass, slow and delirious. Let's be honest. That one's true. That one I didn't make up. That one's, like, we should be able to pick our own stereotypes. You know what I'm saying? We should. We should. It's just crazy. Like, I'm afraid to get pulled over now. Everything that was going down last year, I'm afraid to get pulled over. When I get pulled over now, I'm just like, that, like, cop pulls me over, I'm just like...
Don't shoot, I'm already dead.
You know what I'm saying? It's just, what do you do? Like, seriously, like, I have two BMWs. I'm half Persian tomorrow. I have two BMWs. I said I'm half Persian, I meant it. I have two BMWs, I have one black BMW and one white BMW, and I swear to God, my black BMW gets more parking tickets than my white BMW. They're parked on the same street. How's that even possible? One time I came out, the cops had shot up the black BMW and was like, stop resisting. Like, it's this stupid thing about stereotypes. It's just stupid. It's just something we need to break this habit. Like, why don't we get to choose our own stereotypes? Why don't I get to tell you what stereotypes I get to pick on? You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm half black, half Persian. I'm not the scariest guy in the world. I'm the sexiest guy in the world. I'm so... Half black, half Persian? Yeah. Yeah, because you know what that means. You know what that means. That's black dick Persian credit. What? Yes. Yes. Even though it really sucked about you took me home and I had Persian dick and black credit. Yeah, I speak the Farsi too. That's crazy, right? Immigration loves that. We grow up different in America. It's just a different thing. I don't talk about my mom that much. My mom's black. And if you know about black women, you don't talk about black women. They talk about you. That's just the way it works. That's just the way it works. You know what I'm saying? And the thing is, black parents hit. And I mean, like, white parents, like, time out. They're like, time out. And it's like, shut up, mom! Like, it happens, like, but black parents hit. Like, have you ever been hit? Jamal, were you ever hit with an extension cord? Were you ever hit with an extension cord? And the TV was still attached to it? Like, everybody thinks we're pimping? Nah, nigga, I'm limping. It still hurts. Persian parents don't hit, though. Persian parents... Here's the thing Persian parents do, and it's crazy. Like, they don't hit, they threaten you. They threaten they're gonna hit you, but it's stuff that doesn't hurt, like a flip-flop. Like, come here! Like, they don't hit you. What they do is even worse. What they do is they talk to you. Forever. And then at the end, you're like, Bubba, just hit me, please. Please, I'm so sorry. It's just that growing up in a Persian house, you're like, you learn a lot of things. You learn a lot of things. Like, first of all, you learn Persian parents love their kids more than anyone else in the world. Like, Middle Eastern parents just really love their kids. Like, so much love. That's why we all still live at home. Because we're afraid to leave. Like, Persian kids are the real Iranian hostage crisis. You know what I'm saying? Like, they hold us hostage at home. Like, anytime I want to leave, I feel like I should be able to leave whenever I want now. I'll go to the door, my dad will pop up like a ninja out of nowhere and be like, oh my God, Tehran. Where are you going? Like, he says it like I'm never coming back. Tehran, where are you going? And I'm just like, Bubba, I'm gonna go out, I'll be back. Bubba, you're going out? This time of night? This time of night? Nigga, it is 3 p.m. Bubba, he just does that all the time. And all he does is watch the news. All he does is watch the news. They watch the news, and it can't be good news. It has to be bad news. If it's good news, they will change the channel. Find bad news somewhere. They blame you for it. I got one that's like, see the board in Iraq. I asked you to do two things. Clean your room. Become doctor. You did nothing. It's just, all he does is watch the news. So, hey, where are you going? I'm going to go to the mall, but I'll be back. To the mall? Oh my God. The mall? Do you know what happened at the mall? I was watching the bad news. Do you know what happened at the mall? Two little girls, 8 years old. They were both gonna be doctors. Two little girls, 8 years old. They went to the mall, they got kidnapped, and then killed, and then murdered at the mall. Don't go, Bubba. Because I don't watch the news, I'm like, Bubba, which mall, really? Beverly Center said she's sitting with Paul. Baba. In Nigeria, Baba is watching the Oh my God, don't go. Don't go. Don't go. And then I'm like, Baba, I'm going to the mall. And then straight up hit me like, oh, you want to go to the mall? Then go. Just, you know what? Stay in the goddamn mall. Stay there. Sit there. Don't come back. And the doctor thing, we all got that because we did it. All they want us to do is become doctors. That's it. I mean, you guys are all college students. Well, not all of you, sir. You're like 600 years old. If you're still in college, just drop out. It's done. Let it go. Let the dream go. You know what I'm saying? They have online universities just for you. Who's a like medical student? Who's like, yeah. That's it? Fuck that center. Which one? That's it? There's no more medical students? White kid, what are you?
It switched.
Yeah, what are you? You're the, oh, listen, look at this room. Yeah, you. Just you, John. Just me and you right now.
Computer science.
Computer science. Oh, you're dating the Indian girl. I get it. Smart. That's how you get the Indian girl. That's how you get them. Smart. You got to know how to get these different types of girls, man. That's the thing. Are you dating an Indian guy? See, that's the thing. See how easy you were able to say that you're gay? It was so easy for you? Because you came out and your family probably loves you and it's different. American parents love their kids different. They'll be like, I love you, Tom. That's simple. Middle Eastern parents don't say shit like that. Like, my dad would be like, I love you? Yeah, I love you. It's stupid to try to Olog Ahmad. Like, he has to just chip away. You know what I'm saying? So it's hard when you talk to your parents sometimes. It's difficult. I had to have a conversation with my dad. I had to talk to him over the break. I had to tell him something very difficult. I had to tell my dad that I was gay. And I'm not gay, but I thought it'd be easier to tell my dad that I'm gay than that I wasn't gonna be a doctor. Like, I felt like he would take that news better. I was gonna ease him into it, right? But the thing is, here's the funny thing. I told him, I was like, Bubba, I need to talk to you. He's like, what? I'm watching the news. I'm like, Bubba, I just need to talk to you real quick. I just need to let you know I'm gay. He's like, I know. And I was like, whoa! Bubba, I'm not gay! And he's like, yes, you are, goddammit. You're a gay. I knew you were a gay. You're always going to the goddamn mall. And you're with your boy. I'm like, Bubba, I'm not gay. Oh my God. It's my fault. I named you Tehran. I should have named you Nazmin. What was I thinking? Oh, Nazmin's a city in Iran, like San Francisco. Anyway, whatever. What? I'm like, Bubba, I'm not gay. But he did something that I never expected him to do. I never expected my dad to do this. It's my, like, I've known him my entire life. I never expected. He looked me dead in the eyes and did something. It was like, it touched my heart. He was like, Bubba, you know, even though you're gay, I know you're gay. You're so gay. I just want to let you know. I want to let you know that I love you, no matter what. I love you. You're my son, and I will always love you. And I was like, and he was like, wow. He was like, I want you to know you're my son. I will always love you. And as long as you become a gay doctor, I will always love you. Once my love, become a goddamn dog too. It's just interesting. Growing up, it's just different. It's different. The dynamics are different. Persian parents are tricky. Like, American parents are just, they're straight to the point. You can do things with American parents. Like, you can have friends over. You can't bring friends over when you're Persian. You can't have friends over when you're American. People are like, hey, come on over. Come to my house. I'm like, to your parents' house? Yeah, come on over. And you go there, and it's just crazy because they're just so sweet to you and they're so nice. Persian parents don't do that. You have to train your American friends before they come to your Middle Eastern house. You can't just bring an American. You have to train them, take your shoes off. No, you know what? Take it off at the driveway. Bring it up with you. Don't even be close. When you get in, say hi. Because if they don't say hi, your parents are like, do stuff go man. Like, you have to like work it in. You have to teach them what to do. You have to tell them what to do. You can't just have American friends when you're Middle Eastern. We're raised different. Persian parents, they lie to us. All the time. Seriously, any kid here who's had to fill out a college application with a Persian parent knows exactly what I'm talking about. Because I was like, I needed to fill out my college application, and it was like simple questions, but I didn't know the answers to. And I was like, Bubba, I need your help to fill out this application for college. And he sat down, and I was like, he's like, what's the question? I was like, first question, name. I've been calling this nigga Bubba for 30 years. I don't know his real name. I was like, Bubba, your name, I just need your name. He's like, my name? Tell them. Which one should I put down? What's the next question? I'm like, all right, well, and here's the thing. It was the next one. Birthday. How do Persian parents all have two birthdays? Can someone explain that? Someone explain it, because I'm like, birthday. August. No, don't put that one. September. You know what? Don't even go to college. Just easier. You know, just become doctor. They just say, and that's how they even when they tell us things, like, here you have something that's like, you guys don't have these stories of like how you came to America, how the parent came to America. You guys have things like we could never use, like, I'm black and Persian, I can never go on ancestry.com. There's just nothing for me there. Like, they did not make that. What's it gonna say? It's gonna be like, ancestry.com, you're related to your dad. Like, that's all it has. That's nothing for me. My dad, but when you ask them, we ask them their story, how they came to America, and they tell us, but it's bullshit. Like, my dad will be like, okay, you wanna know how I came to this goddamn country? I was coming here, I had $2 in my pocket. That's it. Like, I don't even go to 7-Eleven without a $5 bill. This nigga left this country. I had $2 in my pocket, and then I'm coming here for you. I walked here from Iran. For you, I asked you two teens. Kid in your room, become doctor. You didn't do nothing. I'm like, Bubba, you know it's impossible to walk here from Iran. And you're like, okay, fine. I'll tell you a story how I met your mother. Your mother, your black mother. I'll tell you a story. Okay, Tedon, here's the story. I was playing the poker, and I'm winning the tickets. I'm winning tickets to the boat. It's the biggest boat. Biggest boat in the world. They say that it can never be breaking, Tedon. It's the biggest boat that can never be breaking. It's so beautiful. And then I saw this woman, and she was so beautiful. She was up, and I was sitting here, and she had a fiance. He was an asshole. And I was like, and then we were on the edge of the boat, and I was holding her, and she was with her arm, and it felt like she was flying. She was flying, and I was like, in the dreams, I love you. I love you. I love you. And then, Tehran, it was so big. But then, there was this jewelry, and there was a piece of the ice in the water. There was a piece of the ice in the water, and Tehran, we're hitting the ice, and the band's playing, we're dancing. But when we're hitting the ice, the boat's breaking, Tehran. The boat's breaking, and the band's still mad. I'm like, shut the fuck up, band, people! And people are falling in the water. People are falling in the water. And I was so cold, it was so cold. And I was like, I will never let you go. I will never let you go. And then I died, Tehran. I died. And she stupid throw the jewelry in the water. And then I came to this goddamn country. I met your mother in the college. She needed credit cards. I needed green cards. We're getting married. And then we're having you. I'm like, Bubba, first of all, that's the storyline to Titanic. Yeah, they stole that from me. I was looking just like Leonardo da Vinci, but I'm having the hair. I look just like him. If you're good, one day I'll tell you the story how I found dinosaur DNA in a mosquito and stuck in a park. Like, he just makes stuff up. Because he's tricky. He's clever. He's tricky. He does that. It's different. It's just different. We go to the airport, he knows he's not allowed. Like, my dad does stuff he knows he's not allowed to do, but he does it anyway. We go to the airport, I don't even know who wears, like, freaking jeans with flip-flops. My dad does, whatever. Going to the airport, I tell him every time, Bubba, you can't take water with you on the flight. He always tries to bring water on the plane. They give you water on the plane, Bubba! Yeah, but it's not my water. Bubba, they give you water. You're not allowed. We get to the freaking security. I'm looking at the water. I swear, I'm like, Bubba, no ob, Bubba. You can't bring water. He looked me dead in the eyes, and he goes, I didn't bring water. I'm looking at the water bottle in his bag. He's like, I didn't bring the water. Mind your goddammit own business. We get to security. Security is obviously like, sir, you're not allowed to bring water on the flight. He's like, I didn't bring the water. The guy's like, sir, I'm looking at the water bottles right there. No, last night I put it in the freezer. It's ice. It doesn't say no ice. It never said no ice. I'm not bringing water. It's tricky. He just does it. And he always has the hookup on everything. It's the Persian hookup on everything. But he always tells me about the hookup after I buy something. Never, like, I'll be like, Bo, you like this watch? Yeah, how much did you get it? Yeah, this is $200. $200? Woo! $200? I buy two Chinese people, they come make one for you at your house. $200? How much could you have got it for? That one? $5. He just has to, and he does that about everything. I had to get tires for my car. Four tires for my car, $250 a tire. You're half Asian. What's that? Four tires, $250 a tire. Go. Wow, like a TI-82. That's amazing. $1,000. $1,000 for four tires. I tell my dad had a heart attack for me. He was like, $1,000? Are you stupid? Oh my God, next time tell me I get you a discount. How much could you have got me four tires for, Bubba? Look me dead in the eyes, goes, four tires for your car? $35. I'm like, Bubba, you could have got my four tires for $35? Swear, he goes like this. Yeah, it's stupid, Tehran, Khariji, fat. Persians call us foreigners, I don't understand why. Let me tell you, next time you gotta do it like Persian way. Next time, you go to Enterprise. You get the car like your car, you bring home. You take tires off Enterprise car, put on your car. You take car back to Enterprise, you get four tires, $35. $35. That's the Iranian name. What did you say? It's just interesting to me. That's why I'm saying you can't bring your friends. You can't, like, bring friends over. Because you can't subject them to this. You can't. Like, you go to an American person's house, they have things, they have, like, ice cream, cookies, amazing things. They're like, hey, Tehran, do you want some treats? You go to a Persian person, it's like, Tehran, does your friend want the raisins? Nobody wants your freaking kishmish, Baba. Nobody wants your kishmish. No one wants your gerdu, Baba. Freaking walnuts. Freaking walnuts. Eats walnuts. You just have to understand. And love, whoa, now that's a different concept in the Middle East. Love is so different. Love is, it's so easy in America to be in love. Like when you're white, you know what I'm saying? It's just easy. When you're white, you get down on one knee, you propose, it's done. Barbara. I love you, Barbara. Like it's so, when you're black, it's easy too. Black guys are so, it's so easy when you're black to propose. Like getting girls when you're black. Black guys just get, like, any girl here knows when you leave the club at night, look straight, go to the car, do not look back. If you hear, hey yo, and you look back, it's like, gotcha, bitch. You know what you better know? You gotta go to the car. Jamal is waiting. Jamal is waiting. Don't be fooled. Don't be fooled by Jamal's mild-mannered demeanor. No. Because black guys are so, and they're so descriptive. It's amazing. So descriptive. Hey, blue shoes. Hey, blue shoes. Fuck you then, bitch. Hey, yellow dress. Yellow dress just saw what happened to blue shoes, Jamal. Yellow dress does not want anything to do with you. But black guys do, there's so much swag. I bet you have so much, you can go up to a girl and say anything you want. Black guy walk up to a girl, just make up stuff like, hey girl, anyone ever tell you you look like a 90 degree angle? Cause girl, you're looking right. That's freaking brilliant. And proposing to a girl when you're black? Oh my, this is my impression. Black guy proposing to a girl. Jamal proposing to a girl.
Hey, yo, baby. Hey, yo, 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 yo. Hey, yo, baby. It's halftime, so. I was thinking, you know what I'm saying? Me and you, we've been together like 4 or 5 years. We have like 5, 6 kids. I think we should. This is not easy! When you're Persian, Jamal, it's not the same at all. When you're Persian, it's not, yo. In Persian, it's a whole ritual, it's a practice, it's called Khastigari, and it's what it sounds like. It's like, you go to the girl's house, you gotta have your parents to meet their parents, you have to take things with you, you have to take flowers, cookies, your bank statement. I mean, it's a process. It is not easy. It is not easy. It is not easy. It is not easy. And here's the thing, I don't know, I want to get married, but I don't know what kind of girl I want to marry. I love, black women are beautiful to me. Black women are beautiful, you're beautiful, beautiful. Like, strong, amazing, intelligent. Black women, watching my mom, I realized black women are the most amazing, beautiful women on earth. You know what I'm saying? Can do anything better than anyone else. I hate them. Can do anything better than anyone else. Except for customer service. And here's the thing about that. Who's even hiring you people to do these jobs? Like, they should get fired, because honestly, why is Sharkeisha working at T-Mobile customer care? She does not care. She does not care. If you call T-Mobile customer care and Miss Shanika Jenkins picks up the phone, hi, this is Miss Shanika Jenkins, how may I help you? Picks up the phone, hang up the freaking phone. Nobody's getting help today. Nobody. No one. I don't want to marry. I don't know what I'm about. Persian girls are beautiful, but Persian women are beautiful. And I like love Persian women, but let's be honest, Persian women are crazy. Persian women are crazy. Middle Eastern women are crazy. Like, no, not even crazy. Crazy people talk to themselves. Middle Eastern women talk to themselves and agree with themselves, which is a whole new level of craziness. It's great. Like, here's the thing. You date an American girl and you do something wrong, Jamal, she's gonna yell at you, she's gonna break up with you. That's it. You do something wrong to a Persian girl, bro, she doesn't break up with you. No, she stays with you. Forever. Sucks your soul out. Like, that's why. Have you seen, like, Persian married couples? All the women look like supermodels and all the guys look like... There's a built-in warning system with Persian girls. Because Persian girl names have meaning. Like, every Persian girl's name means something. What's a common Persian girl? Ziba. What does Ziba mean? Ziba means beautiful. Jamal, Ziba means beautiful. Every Ziba's ugly as shit. I've never seen a beautiful Ziba in my life.